Hi guys, it's Gaz. Welcome to my blog. We are talking about IMDB's top 250 movies. The link is below. Go and check out how many of you seen. So, again, we're doing companion pieces to Wyndham Rice, That Filthy Casual. Hi. Wyndham's channel is down below. You can go down and subscribe to that and check out her videos. Today, all four of these videos have been done in the same day, hence the same attire. I'm not a filthy tramp that just wears the same clothes over and over. I just filmed them all in the same day. So I say today, but it's the same day for all of them. But this video is about the good, the bad, and the ugly. So the first thing you'll notice, actually, go and watch Wyndham's review if you haven't already. Watch that first. You should always watch her review first, because this is a companion to that. Watch Wyndham's video and see if you can spot how she's referencing the previous film. I think it's unintentional, completely. Maybe it is intentional. Maybe she's really much smarter than I've just given her credit for. And it's an intentional nod to the film that she previously reviewed. So go and check that out. I think one of my favourite quotes from Wyndham's review of The Good, the Bad and the Ugly was this: "Sometimes it's the length that does it for me." Read into that what you will, please. Yeah, so there you have it. That's the favourite part of the entire video. Where do we go from there? But on a serious note, The Good, the Bad and the Ugly, directed by Sergio Leone, made in 1966, and Wyndham, I think, gets his spot on. The Westerns typically have always been this kind of stoic, good character, well-moraled, doing these bad things for the right reason. We're supposed to love these characters. And what Sergio Leone does with the characters in The Good, the Bad and the Ugly is just flip that on his head and say, you know what? The Clint Eastwood character, the good Blondie, he's not a good person. You might think he is, but he's taking money from the state by capturing a criminal and then shooting him down after he's received the money and then going to another town to get paid for the ransom for him. They're all as moralless as each other, really. And Sergio Leone just flips that original kind of good cowboy story on his head. The version I've got was 2 hours 34. And that includes an additional 14 minutes of footage that's never been seen before, apparently. So I'm not sure which version Wyndham saw at just under 3 hours. Maybe there's another extended version out there, I'm not sure. But I grew up on Westerns. My dad was a big Western fan. So we used to sit and watch all the Clint Eastwood stuff. Pale Rider, High Plains Drifter, Unforgiven, and obviously the Fistful of Dollars, Few Dollars More, and The Good, the Bad, the Ugly. So my dad still loves Westerns now. So I kind of grew up on them. So I'd seen this film before. It was the second time I watched it. I just watched it recently again for this review. The score is amazing. Ennio Morricone. It's a fantastic score. It's iconic. The part of the story, the score that I love, is the Ecstasy of Gold, which is the music that's playing when Eli Wallach's character, the ugly, is running towards the graveyard near the end. And if you've ever seen Metallica play live, they open with that. So I've seen them a couple of times, and they open with that particular piece of music, the Ecstasy of Gold, and they have the two times I saw that, they had that scene play on the big video screen at the end of The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly. And it's an amazing piece of music. I love the fact as well, like Wyndham said, that each character had their own instrument. So here's a question for you, Wyndham. And in fact, anyone else, in the comments below, and Wyndham, you can reply. What instrument would you be? There you go, if you want to answer it. No one answers on a postcard. That doesn't happen anymore. Nobody sends postcards anymore. Except me to my mum sometimes. My mum loves postcards. So if I go somewhere, I send her a postcard. Other than that, for competitions, nobody sends postcards. Comment below. So yeah, what instrument would you be? But that's really cool that each character gets their own instrument. But I think Wyndham got it spot. You know, I don't mind a long film. I love to be engrossed in a film. For me, a movie is like an escape. So, you know, the longer the film, the better. Wyndham, you are going to love, and I mean love, Once Upon a Time in America, when that comes up, which is Sergio Leone's gangster epic. And I say epic, I mean that in the greatest sense of the word. Because it's over 4 hours long. Anyway, so yeah, The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly. It's one of the best westerns, I think, of that, you know. The western genre is one of the best, definitely. It's got a great score. Clint Eastwood is superb in it, as is Lee Van Cleef and Eli Wallach. Sergio Leone's, you know, the opening scene, the really long slow shot of the two guys walking into town, you know, it's fantastic. And I think you can see, you know, I'm a big fan of Martin Scorsese, and I think you can see where they get some of their influence from with shots like that from Sergio Leone. So, you know, the direction was superb. You know, it's a great film. I agree with Wyndham. I'd go 7 out of 10. I think, as I say, Wyndham got it spot on with the review. I do sometimes think that she looks a little bit too much into the film. Like, the city on the hill. It's just a city on a hill. Like, you know, she talks about that to get to the hill and back, you know, you have to get everywhere with a horse and car. And if you, you know, one misstep and you're dead. You know, I don't think that really matters. I don't think it matters. But, on the whole, great film, great review. I'll link Wyndham's page below, That Filthy Casual. Check her out, subscribe to my page. You can do that right above the link to Wyndham's page. And click on the link to the IMDB top 250 movies. And check how many you have seen. I will see you next time.